I'm delighted to be joined by Reverend Kim Gambino, who's here today. Thank you, Kim, so much for being here. She is going to talk to us about her Valentine's Day coat drive and also about the Helping Hands Rescue Mission, which is in the heart of Huntington Station by the train station, and was founded by your parents, Jim and Rosemary Gaines, along with your grandmother, Florence, in 1965. I'm told they started the mission with $125 from their honeymoon, is that right?
They did.
And now, 56 years later, still serving the community, particularly 2020 was a tough year. Can you tell us about how the mission was in the community and what they were doing during that time?
Sure. The mission has been serving over the last 56 years, but last year in March, things changed for everyone in the nation and in the world, but dynamically at the mission. We went from serving about 83 families a week to, in the height of pandemic, serving over 500 food pantry families a week.
Oh my gosh, so what an uptick.
It was such an uptick, and it's leveled out now. We have between about 150 and 200 families a week now, so things have leveled out a bit, but it's been a very busy year.
and when does that take place? Are there appointed hours for that?
Yes, Tuesday through Friday from 11 to 1, and then if people can't make it during that time, they can make an appointment to come to pick up food or to look through our coats and things.
And we're going to talk about the coat drive, but it's obviously food donations still being accepted.
Yes, food comes and goes so quickly.
And what are the parameters on food donations?
We accept all non-perishable food items. We do have a list on our website, and we actually started a new thing called Fill a Bag, Feed a Family. So we have a list of what to put in a food bag that will go specifically to a family to help us to get those bags out every week.
Yeah, I was delighted to be a part of that at Thanksgiving.
Yes, the
terrific.
Fill a Box.
All the fixings, Fill a Box.
Yes.
A gift card for the
yes.
turkey, and really was terrific.
Yes, so we just adapted that into a thing that can be ongoing to help to fill the bags.
And I think, you know, even nowadays we're all sort of push button, and we were just talking about Amazon. But even with that, I was able to go on Target and just click, click, click. I got, I think, 90% of it there. And, you know, those of us who are being, concerned about COVID, Target, they just put it out to my car, put it in my back seat, and I paid that way, and it was quick and easy. So it's not even, I guess, the point being, it's not as labor intensive as
no.
even it used to be.
Sure, and some people even just have it shipped directly to the mission. We get Target boxes. It's like Christmas.
That's great. That is really, really
it's
great.
It's very good.
So we want to talk about, it's cold out, it's particularly cold today, and we still want to help those in need. And what are you doing for Valentine's Day?
Well, we've had a tremendous coat need this year. With the influx of more families comes an influx of people in need of coats, and especially with children and coats for children and men and women. So, you know, this is a time that we think of love, and I love to give hugs. We can't really give a hug, but giving someone a coat, a nice warm coat, is like giving them a hug. So we're accepting coat donations Tuesday through Friday from 10 to 11 or 1 to 4 or on Mondays from 10 to 2. And Saturdays from 10 to 1, and people can bring the coats, and we have racks that they can hang them up on, and we give them out between 11 and 1 Tuesday through Friday.
And any areas of particular need when it comes to coats and
children's
accessories?
Children's sizes. We cannot keep children's sizes from about 2T all the way up to size like 14, 16. Those just go out so quickly.
And what a great way to people out there in the town. Spring cleaning early. Just start, look in those closets. I mean, how many of us have old winter coats that are never going to get
sure.
used? We can free up some space in the closet and help someone out. I know we just, in our family, just went through our cedar closet that we were fortunate enough to have in the basement, and 6-7 bags full of clothes that we were, you know, never gonna get used again, but could be put to good use. So that's terrific. Where are you located?
We're at 225 Broadway in Huntington Station. It's 5 blocks east of the Huntington Station Railroad.
Right. And if we Google you, we can find you.
You can
Helping
find
Hands
us, yes.
Rescue Mission. And a lot of useful information there. You can join your email distribution
yes.
list that I think is great.
Oh, thank
you. Do a great job of keeping people in the loop, because I think there's, you know, people want to help. It's just a matter of making the time to help. And you... your organization has been very innovative at making it easy for people to help and address this critical mission. So, Reverend Gambino, we thank you so much.
Oh, thank you. And we've missed having so many volunteers that usually come to the mission come, so we've been really trying to find ways that they can help, because to some people it means the world to be able to do something for someone who's in need.
Yeah, that's great. Okay, well, we'll be back to normal soon.
I know. I can't wait.
Yeah, okay.
Thanks.
Thank you.